Sao. Well, sao in Northern Thai language means 20. Yeah, 20. In Central Thai, we say 20. But in Northern Thai, they say sao. For example, 25. In Central Thai, we say 25. But in Northern Thai language, they say sao ha. Sao ha. For example, if I would like to say I'm 28, then I would say Chan ayu sao pet. And today I'm gonna teach you 23 Lanna language. Well, Lanna words. So Lanna words refer to the Northern Thai language. As I've been living here in Chiang Mai in the north of Thailand for almost 9 years, so I pick up some words, well, a lot, and some sentences. But if you ask me to speak Northern Thai language, well, I can speak, but I cannot imitate the accent. Well, most of my friends come from Lampang, so among the friends, they always speak dialect with the Lampang accent. But in Chiang Mai, which the Chiang Mai accent is a little bit slower, more calm, but I can't speak with the accent. I just pick up, I know the meaning. I can't speak without the accent, but well, today I'm gonna teach you some words, because when I first came here 9 years ago, I got a lot of confusions and misunderstanding between me and my friend, or me, the seller, because I couldn't understand anything that they say. My friend, they even set like a project, set up the project to teach me one Lanna word one day. Like I'm learning the new language in that time. Like that example. So to say Lanna language in Thai, we say U Kam Mueang. U Kam Mueang. U means to speak, and Kam Mueang come from Kam Mueang, which means Lanna language. So today we're gonna U Kam Mueang Gan Na Jiao. So let's get started. So number one, the first one is Sao. Sao. Well, sao in Northern Thai language means 20. Yeah, 20. In Central Thai, we say 20. But in Northern Thai, they say sao. For example, 25. In Central Thai, we say 25. But in Northern Thai language, they say sao ha. Sao ha. For example, if I would like to say I'm 28, then I would say Chan ayu sao pet. Sao pet. So I've got a lot of like funny situations with the word sao. So when I first came here, I went to Merim with my mom and my sister, and then we stopped by the like a kiosk for the ice cream, like coconut ice cream, and then I ordered 3 coconut ice cream with a cone, and then the seller said sao baht, and I was like, I was so shocked, like, wow, very cheap. I thought it means 3 baht. Sam baht. I was like, I told my mom, I want to live here forever because the ice cream is just 3 baht. But then my mom was like, oh really, it's so cheap. And then I hand him the 20 baht bank, the note, and then he was confused, like, what is that? And I was like, yeah, you told sao baht for each, so three coconut ice cream is 9 baht, so it's enough, right? And then he was laughing like so bad, like laughed a lot. And then he said sao baht means 20 each. And I was like, oh, it means 20, it's not 3 baht. So yeah, I feel like a bit embarrassed. Yeah, but that's one of the funny situations that happened to me because of the misunderstanding of the language. Yeah, so have you ever used the word sao before? The second one is toy. Toy. Toy means duai. Duai in Central Thai, which means as well or also. So if I want to say kin duai, kin duai, I also eat, then in Northern Thai language, I would say kin toi, kin toi, or pai duai, pai duai. I would say pai toi, pai toi. So, riêng phasa Thai toi. Number 3. Pun. Pun means I, pom, or chan. For example, if I would like to say my name is Mind, in Central Thai I would say chan chư mai, chan chư mai. But in Northern Thai I would say pân chư mai, pân chư mai. And number 4, tuá, tuá. Tuá in Central Thai it means a ticket, but in Northern Thai it means you, you. For example, if I would like to say who are you, who are you, in Northern Thai I would say tuá bên krai, tuá bên krai. So as I've been living here and I notice a lot that in the Northern Thai language they always have like the rising tone or the high tone, tuá, pai, or stuff like that. So pân chư mai, tuá chư arai. And then number 5, I. I means P, but for male. So P chai in Northern Thai we say I and followed by their name. For example, I Brad Pitt, P Brad Pitt. And for the older person who is a female, then we say P. For example, P mai. I Brad Pitt and P Angelina, stuff like that. You can call them like, you can call someone who is older than you I, but he has to be a man. And P for a girl, no, for a woman, yeah. And then number 6, because P is number 5, so here is number 6. I'm not going to blame you or anything, but this word is ngao. Ngao with ngo ngu or ng sound. Ngao. Ngao means ngo. Ngo in Central Thai, which means stupid. Stupid. So you can say bak ngao, you stupid. Or chat ngao, super stupid. But don't say it to anyone, just say it to your friend. Chat ngao, bak ngao. But the best thing is try not to say this to anyone. Number 7, kai. In Central Thai, it means bua, which means bored. Kai, I'm bored. Or kai khanat, khanat. Like in Central Thai, it means the size, but in Northern Thai, it means very. So if I say kai khanat, it means oh, very bored. Kai ko, are you bored? And then ko is the question word, yes or no. For example, I said kai ko, are you bored? Hiu ko, are you hungry? Ron ko, are you hot? The weather hot. I'm hot. Yeah. Number 9. Good. Good with high tone. Good means kid. Kid, which means to think. Gudwa. To think that. Or to miss someone, we say could hot lie. Could hot lie. Bun could hot I lie. I miss you a lot. So number 10. Very fast, we are at number 10 now. 10, the word is Tè means jing, which means real. So if you want to say really, in Central Thai we say jing rò, but in Northern Thai we say tè ka, or you can say tè ka. And if you want to say yes, really, jing in Thai, not in Central Thai, but tè ka, like this, is real. So if you have high tone at the end or rising tone at the end, it refers to the question sentence. But if you have low tone at the end, it refers to the statement. For example, tè ka and tè ka is the question word, while tè ka means the statement is real. So tè ka. And then number 11, ya in Central Thai it is tham, which means to do or to make. Also, if I would like to say what are you doing, คุณทำอะไร, I would say ยะหยัง. Yang means alright, so do what? ยะหยัง. So now, what are you doing? กำลังยะหยัง. And then number 12 or 12. 12, I have talked about this word before at the beginning of the sentence, which is ooh. It means pood, which means to speak. So yeah, do you know that ooh in Central Thai it means being lazy and skip from work, even though you're at the workplace, then you ooh ngan is a verb, means to ooh. But in Northern Thai language it means to speak. For example, I say ooh kam meung, right? Ooh kam meung, speak Northern Thai language. If I would like to say I can't speak Northern Thai language, I would say ooh kam meung ba dai. ooh kam meung dai ko. Number 13, lucky number in Thai. Well, not in Thai, I have to say the word first. Well, the word is wan pu, which means prung ni or tomorrow. So with this word, I had one bad experience about this word, because my friends say okay, wan pu zhe gan, it means see you tomorrow, right? Let's meet tomorrow. But by that time, I didn't know the meaning of wan pu. I thought she was mispronounced it, wan put, which means Wednesday. So the next day I didn't show up because I thought it was in Wednesday, not tomorrow. So my friend called me like, "Mine, where are you?" I was like, "Oh, I'm at the dorm, why?" And I was like, and she was like, "No, we are waiting for you here." I was like, "Why do you need to wait for me now? Because we have an appointment on Wednesday." And then she was laughing and said, "No, it's today." And I was like, "How come it's today? You say one put, which means Wednesday." And she said, "No, it's one pook, which means tomorrow." So I missed the appointment because of this one pull and one put, and I will remember this situation until I die. Yeah. Number 14. Lam. Lam. I think most of you know this word. Lam means delicious, yummy. So, when I first came here, well, the first that I experienced the north, I went to Lampang, and then in the morning, I went to like a morning market, a local morning market, and then I bought the patongko, like a Chinese bun, like the fried bun, and then the seller asked me, Lamko, Lamko, and I was like, what? And I was like, what? And she said again, Lamko. Well, I understand go, but I don't understand. I didn't understand lam. Lam in Thai, with ro rua, it should be ram, means Thai dance, like this, Thai dance. And I was like, why? I was thinking in my mind, like, why do I need to dance here? Lam go. I was like, so I asked her like quietly, like, do I need to lam here? Like, tong lam lo ha? Tong lam lo ha? And then she was laughing, like, around that, like, the sailors around the area was like looking at me, was like laughing, like, kiko, like this. And then she said, oh, lam means delicious. I was like, oh, it means delicious. I didn't know because I come from Bangkok. And then I was like, yeah, shai kha aroi, aroi, lam kha lam. That's the first Northern Thai word that I've learned, actually, lam go, lam go. So, which food is lam for you? Lam go. And then 15 is hu, with sara u. Hu means hai, hai, which means four. For example, ao hu noi, ao hu noi, means ao hai noi, ao hai noi. Get that for me, ao hu noi, ao hu noi, ao hu noi dai go. Can you get that for me? And then number 16 or 16 is the word bo. Bo means mai, no, which means no. For example, mai kin. In Northern Thai, we say bakin, bakin. Mai ao, ba ao, ba ao. Mai hiu, ba hiu, ba hiu. So how to use bo is used as mai, exactly the same, just change mai to bo. Ba kin, ba ao, ba hiu, ba ao leo, ba lam, ba whatever. Yeah, you can say that, ba also, but it literally means, actually it say bo, but you can also say ba with start a as well. Number 17, kai. Kai in Northern Thai language means to want or yak in Central Thai. Kai, but the word kai pronounced exactly the same in Central Thai means fever, but it's written differently. It's written like this. So kai means to want. For example, oh, that guy is so handsome. Kai dai. I want to have him. Or, this gift is very beautiful. I want it. Kai dai. Or, I want to eat that food. Kai kin. Kai kin. Or, you want to shout. Like, if you get so stressful, like very stressful, and then you want to shout, and then you can say, kai hui. Kai hui. Hui means to shout. Kai hui. So if you really wanted to shout, then you can say, kai hui khanat, ไข้หุยขนาด or if you wanna cry we say ไข้ไห้ไข้ไห้ so now ไข้ไห้ number 18 lang lang means eveningIn Central Thai, you say yen, yen. For example, khao lang. Khao lang means dinner, dinner. Khao lang. Or lang ni, this evening. Lang ni tua cha tham arai. Or lang ni tua cha ya yang. Lang ni tua cha ya yang. This evening, what will you do?What will you do this evening? Number 19. Ayang, or yang. Yang with rising tone means what, arai, yes. In Northern Thai, they say ayang or yang. For example, ya ayang, do what? Kin ayang.Kin ayang, eat what? So, sometimes I say like, when I'm busy doing something and then someone asks me something and I was like, ayang? Like, what? Like that. Number 20 or sao, remember? Sao. So, this word is very important. So, it's the word to eat,In Thai, in Central Thai, we say gin, gin. But in Northern Thai, you have to put the rising tone for this word. So you say gin, gin. As I told you before, I've noticed that in the Northern Thai language, they always use the rising tone and high tone a lot. So gin, 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 gin ayang, kai gin.So that's how we use the word gin or gin in Northern Thai language. Gin cafe, stuff like that. I really can't imitate the accent. Well, I'm so sorry about that. And then number sao it or 21. So 21 is the word big, see, high tone.Big means to go back. For example, big ban, go back home. Kajai, big ban, kai gin. Kajai is another word that I'm gonna teach you. It means fast, hurry up. Kajai, big ban.Go home, hurry up to go home. Kai gin, kai hiu. So like I'm hungry, I want to eat. So kajai, you can say kajai. Big ban, like that. And then number sao song. Sao song I use this a lot. It says badai. It's like the just.You just do it. For example, tham badai, I just eat. Gin badai, just go. Bai badai, or it can be like nam badai. Nam badai means just water, so it's mean like just normal water. Nam plao, nam badai. Ban badai, oh, it's just a house.เสื้อบะดายIt's just a shirt. So it's badai means just. I use this a lot. Just come here, badai. I don't want to do anything. I just come because I'm bored. Just come here, badai. So what? And the last one. Sao sam. Or 23. It's yom. This is an adjective which I can't.Find the word for this. Well, it can be boring or bored. It can use It can be used to describe your feeling. For example, รู้สึกยมรู้สึกยม it means you feel like you bored, you annoying, like yum. But if we use the word yum for food, for example, like French fry, if the French fry is yum, then it means it's not crispy, it's not crunchy anymore. It's like this. Yeah, that's yum. You can say, huh, yum. That thing is yum. And the French fry is yum. Lúc chín is yum. So yum is like adjective to say it's not like not that good, not active, like not like bored. Yeah, stuff like that. So that's all for the video today. I hope you find it interesting for you and I hope you find it enjoyable. And yeah, because I was thinking that like on Loic Atong, I was walking around the mud by myself and I was thinking like, yeah, I should do something about the Northern Thai language since I've been here for so long. And I know that some of my followers and some of my students, they are living here. So I think it might be helpful for them to know some of the Northern Thai language. And it's fun to learn. Yeah, it's really fun to learn with the accent, the sound, everything is completely new for me. Like, and I'm sure that if you talk the Northern Thai language with your Northern Thai friend, they're gonna be impressed and they will find you very cute for sure. Yeah, I will see you in the next video. Sawadee ka. Bye bye. Oh, I should have said. Sawadee jao.